Thank you, Dr. J. Madhavi and Mrs. B. Sudharani. Going further, we speak on communication. The austerity of speech is speaking words that are truthful, unoffending, pleasing, and beneficial for the listener, and always speak the truth in such a way that is pleasing to others. The sloka here goes, Swadhyaya Bhyasanam Chaiva Vangmayam Tapa Uchyate. Now, I call upon Mr. Kuldeep Rai to take the stage.
At the outset, I would like to thank the management of Marwari Siksha Samiti and especially Dr. D.V.G. Krishna, our director, sir, for this opportunity. My subject is communication. Communication involves transmission of information, opinions, feelings, emotions, animations, voice, sounds, images, videos, applications, and data over a medium. Communication is complete when transmission is followed by reception. Without reception, it is incomplete. The greatest communicator ever born is Sri Krishna. And the greatest example of communication is Bhagavad Gita, which literally means the song of God. Within 700 slokas, it explains the profoundest truths of life by Sri Krishna. Swami Vivekananda was another great communicator. He represented Hinduism at the Parliament of World's Religions in Chicago in the year 1893. And started his speech with brothers and sisters. This was unprecedented, and he deeply influenced the materialistic world. Communication can be non-verbal also. Non-verbal communication uses our eyes, smile, frown, and body language. Mahabharata provides a beautiful example of bad use of non-verbal communication and how it can affect the outcome. When Draupadi was being insulted by Dushasan, at that instant, Duryodhana slapped his own thigh. This was a vulgar gesture. It was noticed by Bhim, and at that time, Bhim vowed that he will break the thighs of Duryodhana in war. So thus, this vulgar non-verbal communication led to the death of Duryodhana. In olden times, wars were fought on battlefields like Kurukshetra. Today, they are fought in electromagnetic waves. They are fought through hacking of networks and feeding misinformation to the enemy. Once misinformation is fed, their systems collapse and we can easily defeat them. Again, Mahabharata provides a beautiful example of using miscommunication to win a battle. Yudhishthira was asked to say the words Ashwatthama Hata Kunjara. The last word was uttered in a very low volume. Almost it could not be heard. Drona thought that his son Ashwatthama had been killed. He laid down his weapons and then it was possible for them to kill Drona. So this was a good example of using miscommunication for winning a battle. This is what is used in modern cyber warfare also. Communication is the basis for business, management, teamwork, motivation, and strategy. Communication is impossible without a medium. There is a huge variety of media available to us. The medium of communication can be wired or wireless, analog or digital, audio, image or audiovisual. It can be mass media, telecommunication media, print media, electronic media, radio waves, high frequency, very high frequency, ultra high frequency, microwave, or the latest one, millimeter waves. Mobile communication networks also have options: 3G, 4G, 5G. Communication media also includes Wi-Fi or WiMAX. Communication can be through terrestrial media or satellite media. It can be encrypted or non-encrypted. In cyber warfare, there is a great importance of decrypting the encrypted information. If we are able to do that, we can win the war very easily. Before I conclude, I would like to once again thank the management of MSS, Marwadi Siksha Samiti, and especially